Hey everyone, I'm meteorologist Matt Serwey. A lot of rain still coming in, and we're getting even more reports of flooding across parts of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. So let's jump right into it. Here's a live look from one of our sky cams. This is from the TD Ameritrade headquarters in the Old Mill area, so 108th and Dodge, give or take. And this is the Papio Creek. This was running high today, but this is some of the highest water I've ever seen in the Papio Creek. And it's just going to keep rising a little more as we go into the afternoon. A common sight around a lot of waterways in eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. It's 45 right now with a southeast wind, and it is dumping rain. So let's take a little radar tour here. Dual pole super Doppler shows some embedded heavier pockets of rain. One right now coming out of the north side of Bellevue, about to move into the Lake Manawa area in Council Bluffs, Fox Run, south side of Council Bluffs, and eventually downtown Omaha. I'll zoom back out a little bit, and you can see that off to our north, and I want to kind of highlight this area because I'm getting a lot of flood reports out of northern Dodge County, out of parts of Colfax and Butler counties. Lots of water over roadways in those places, and they still have a lot of steady to heavy rainfall coming down. And if I drag this off to the south, you can still see that it extends all the way down to the Kansas border with this widespread steady to heavy rain. We're not seeing as much lightning as we were earlier this morning, but we could still have some embedded rumbles of thunder. Switching radar sources here and putting it into motion, you can see how we have all these yellows and oranges and reds indicating the steady to heavy rainfall. Everything lifting north across eastern Nebraska. So places that already have high water reports, like Highway 15 south of Schuyler, which is closed because of high water. Around the Columbus area, I'm seeing pictures of roadways about to get covered by water. Those places still have an hour or two of very heavy rainfall left. Western Iowa, around Red Oak, I've heard reports of water covering the roadways in Montgomery County as well. You all still have another couple of hours of very heavy rainfall. So the bottom line is, flooding is a big concern through this afternoon, not just along waterways, but even normal roadways could get standing water on them because we've had so much water over the last couple of days, so much snow melt. That's why we have what's called an aerial flood warning in effect for most of the KETV viewing area. That means areas could be covered by water. It's not specific to rivers and other waterways. As I zoom back out, this is an incredibly strong area of low pressure winding up across parts of southeast Colorado, pushing out into Kansas. And we still could see more moisture coming up from Kansas as we go into the afternoon. The dry air is going to try to wrap in here, and it will later on tonight. But through this afternoon, we could still get a few more isolated thunderstorms here or there with some locally heavy rainfall totals. Just another point of emphasis, Interstate 80 west of Ogallala is closed in Nebraska. So any plans to drive toward the Panhandle today, down toward Denver, that's not happening because they're expecting blizzard conditions. One good thing about the rain coming in, I know there's not a lot of good, but at least it's getting the fog out of here. Still some areas of dense fog toward Atlantic and Carroll. And when we do dry out a little bit this afternoon, it's possible we see this dense fog come back. Temperatures, mid to upper 40s in Omaha, been that way all morning, and we'll climb into, they're in the low to mid 50s down to our south. Once we dry out this afternoon, we will make a run into the mid and upper 50s. So let's look at how this plays out on Storm Predictor. You can see the heavier rain bands wrapping in through the early afternoon. Here's 3 o'clock, still the potential for isolated rain and embedded thunderstorms and embedded downpours. You can see during the late afternoon and evening, more of the same. Isolated rain, isolated downpours with areas of fog in between. 10 o'clock tonight, we start looking off to our west. Here comes that area of low pressure. You can see that little swirl right over Omaha. That would indicate that low pressure is sitting right over us tomorrow morning. Light rain possible here. You can see the rain mixing with snow off to our north and west early tomorrow morning. And then as that area of low pressure moves to our north and east, we are going to get very strong and very cold northwest winds tomorrow, and that's going to change any rain to a rain-snow mix as we go through the afternoon. And this is going to be a very slushy snowfall. Not a lot of it is going to stick on the ground right away because you know how wet it is out there. It's tough to get snow to stick with conditions like this. Additional rainfall, a lot of locations have anywhere between a half inch and an inch of rain already, and we could add about another half inch to an inch on those same totals. A line from about David City through Hooper toward Tecama and Denison. You all had an inch and a half earlier this morning, and you could pick up another inch and a half through this afternoon. That's not good for flooding. Wind gusts also will be an issue. You can see wind gusts out of the south between about 35 and 45 miles an hour to the south today. And then as that area of low pressure gets close to us, winds will actually calm down late tonight into early Thursday. But look off to our west. Tomorrow morning already by daybreak, 50 to 60 mile an hour wind gusts possible. Norfolk, Columbus, York, through Lincoln. And those strong winds are going to wrap into the remainder of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa through the middle of Thursday and continue all the way through the afternoon. So peak wind gusts pretty much anywhere could be between about 45 and 55 miles an hour, with those 60 mile an hour wind gusts possible west of Omaha and especially west of the Fremont area. Snowfall, yeah, we could pick up a little bit of slush on the back end of it. I'm saying under an inch for the majority of eastern Nebraska and western Iowa. That includes the Omaha Metro, but places like David City, Columbus, West Point could pick up an inch or two. And then the farthest west part of our viewing area, toward Norfolk and maybe York, might pick up locally 2 to 4 inches. So warm today, windy with the locally heavy rain. The rain changes to snow, and we get even stronger winds in here on Thursday. Temperatures holding most of the day in the upper 30s to near 40, and still kind of breezy on Friday, but there's a good sign. Sun is back in the forecast on Friday. So as always, never, ever, ever drive across water-covered roads, especially if it's over a river current. That could easily carry your car away, and you don't know what kind of condition the road is underneath that fast-moving water. So never drive across those water-covered roads. You can always stay up to date with where the heavy rainfall is, the latest flood reports, the KETV mobile app, and KETV.com. Lauren Robinson's going to be in to update your forecast on Newswatch 7 at noon, and Chief Meteorologist Bill Ramby will be in a little later on today. Stay safe, stay dry, stay smart, everyone, if you're doing some traveling. I'll see you tomorrow morning on First News.